The video game market crash of 1983 left a young Nintendo, in the gaming scene at least, scrambling for ideas to create and advertise their newest product. The Family Computer System, otherwise known as Famicom in Japan, and more familiarly as the NES, would of course go on to become a legendary gaming system. At the time, however, the idea of buying a plain old game system was tanking, so Nintendo needed something to spice it up. To do so, they conceived a very special interactive toy that would sell with early NES consoles. What does any of this have to do with Smash? Well, it just so happens that that toy was called Robotic Operating Buddy, or as you may know him, ROB. Rob was actually only compatible with two games, Gyromite and Stack Up of Nintendo's Robot series. The interactive robot was a neat gimmick, but goes down in history mostly as an advertising tool that drew eyes to Nintendo's breakout console. Rob would go on to appear in many games, such as Star Topics and F-Zero GX. If you look carefully, he still shows up in Port Town Aerial Drive. His first reappearance as a playable character would be in Mario Kart DS for, well, the DS. But a new legacy would begin for the lovable robot in 2008. Super Smash Bros. Brawl featured Rob as an unexpected newcomer, and also a prominent character in the game's adventure mode. In competitive play, Rob was initially seen as a top tier due to his reliable projectile zoning and strong normals, but gradually dropped to upper mid tier as juggles and chain grabs were optimized. Rob returned in Smash 4 with notable buffs to his kill power. His down throw would true combo into up air at kill percents, often nicknamed the Beep Boop combo after Diddy's Hoo-Ha. Although upscaled from Brawl, Smash 4 buffed plenty of other characters as well, leaving him in a similar tier list position. Even so, Rob was well represented by players such as 8-Bit Man, Mr. Eric, and Raffy X. Finally, in Smash Ultimate, Rob returns in most likely his strongest appearance. Universal changes such as 3-frame jump squats coupled with general moveset buffs immediately led players to conclude that the new Rob was a viable character. His large hurtbox and poor disadvantage state are still taken into account though, leading most players to consider him a high tier. With Zachary achieving excellent results and nerfs to bad matchups such as Palutena, some think that Rob could even be a top tier. So for our question of the day, where do you put Rob? Is he a high tier, or does he squeeze his way into top tier in Ultimate? Let us know in the comments and stay tuned as we disassemble this robot. If you want to learn more about Rob, you'll find in-depth character guides on every fighter on ProGuides.com. We've got tons of resources at your disposal, such as live classes where you can play with pros, and our InstaPro platform that connects you to the best coaching around. Check out ProGuides.com today. So, for Rob's strengths, we mentioned his zoning capabilities, but he has so much more, and there's a lot of depth in his zoning too. Rob's most essential tool is the gyro. This spinning top-like item plays a huge part in Rob's neutral and beyond. He can charge up the gyro with his down special, and when he lets it rip, it will shoot out and eventually stop and spin in place. While spinning, the gyro has an active hitbox that the player who threw it is immune to. This mechanic is very useful. It shuts off part of the ground for the opponent, similar to Diddy Kong's banana peel, and will be difficult for them to pick up. The spinning gyro's active hitbox also acts as a wall that can interrupt other projectiles, helping Rob combat fellow zoners. With gyro limiting opponents on the ground, many will seek to jump over it, which Rob can easily thwart with his amazing anti-aerial options. His neutral special, the Robo Beam, can be aimed in a variety of angles that allow Rob to snuff out players as they jump over gyro. This move is also great for edgeguarding and just zoning in general, as it's transcendent, travels very far, and it's pretty strong at full charge. The Robo Beam isn't Rob's only way to pressure the air, however. Rob's neutral air may not seem like much with its sluggish frame 14 startup, but this aerial has large disjointed hitboxes and only 7 frames of landing lag, making it a very good walling option in many situations. When he needs a faster, more reactionary anti-aerial, his forward air comes out on frame 6 and is sure to stuff most aerial approaches. Getting in on Rob is definitely tough, but surely his close-up options aren't so great like traditional zoners, right? Oh. Yes, for a character who excels at camping, Rob's boxing tools are actually, well, amazing. And there's no better place to start than with his down tilt. Down tilt is frame 3, the same frame as many characters' jabs, and oh, it's also -5 on shield. That means you can't even shield grab a point-blank down tilt. And being a grounded move, Rob doesn't have to space it vertically to achieve that frame advantage. Okay, but it's not like he can combo off down tilt, right? Right. Not only can Rob combo out of down tilt, but it's one of his best combo starters. At certain percents, Rob can even carry you across the stage with down tilt and set up for an edge guard, and at high percents, it opens up tech chase opportunities that can lead to a smash attack KO. Rob actually has a very solid combo game in general. His neutral air offers great reward for successfully walling opponents out, and it can combo into almost any aerial in the right situation. It can also link into Rob's side special, Arm Rotor, which is actually really strong in Ultimate. This creates a crazy setup that Rob can use to true combo you from zero to death. To understand this setup, we also have to look at gyro combos. We mentioned how gyro acts as a great obstacle when left on the stage, but it does way more than that. When thrown as an item, Rob can combo the gyro into aerials, and it's also a great option for edgeguarding. By Z-dropping the gyro, he can hit his opponent with it and also combo into a nair, which then catches the gyro again. Repeating this process will carry the opponent closer to the blast zone, where a gyro to side B can close out the stock. You won't see this full setup in real matches too often, but it's definitely a practical combo. More realistically, pieces of this setup, such as Nair to Gyro side B, are quite common in top-level Rob gameplay. The Arm Rotor is also a popular option for edgeguarding and ledge trapping, thanks to its KO power and long-lasting hitboxes. Gyro can also be used for ledge trapping setups and offers general combos from its spinning hitbox. By placing a spinning gyro at the ledge and standing at a roll's distance, Rob can cover almost any option the opponent chooses from ledge while the gyro spins. If the opponent gets up into the gyro, it will lightly knock them away in the direction Rob was facing when he placed it. This leads to true combos from a down air spike offstage or a smash attack on stage. If the opponent rolls to avoid the gyro, they'll be heading straight into Rob, where he can likewise go for a smash attack. These spinning gyro setups work in conjunction with down tilt too. If there happens to be a gyro in your path as Rob carries you forward with down tilt, which there likely will be, he can pinball you back and forth, finishing with a forward smash. Rob's disadvantage state is one of his weaknesses, but it's actually pretty difficult to deal with. His nair is a fantastic landing option that creates 50-50 scenarios, wherein you'll have to call out the nair and punish its startup, or wait and hope he nairs early so you can hit him before he lands. Offstage, Rob is a big target, but a very maneuverable one. His up special, Rob Burner, allows him to travel just about anywhere on a full tank of fuel, and he has all sorts of tricks to mix up his direction and stall. Rob can also attack, double jump, and air dodge out of his up B, so you'll have to be really careful edgeguarding a smart Rob player. Alright, so Rob is a great zoner with deadly combos and solid boxing tools. So what's holding him back? First and foremost, Rob is big. It may not sound like much, but having a large and wide hurtbox is actually a huge detriment in any Smash game. Put simply, it just makes him easier to hit, in any situation. Rob will have trouble avoiding stray hitboxes in neutral, and he gets comboed and juggled super hard. His forward and up airs are his only aerials faster than frame 10, so he has nothing to defend himself from an opponent right underneath him. Because of this, Rob will be forced to ledge in some matchups, and his large size also makes him very easy to ledge trap. Rob is great at boxing, but not once he puts his shield up. Rob's fastest out of shield option is fair, which is frame 9 with jump squat, so he'll find it very difficult to escape shield pressure. This can be mitigated if Rob has a gyro in hand, but still limits him to few obvious choices. These weaknesses are evident in top-level play. Perhaps the best example is Void's victory over Zachray. Zachray was often considered the best Rob in the latest offline meta, and Sheik has been seen as a mid or even lower-tier character. However, Sheik's oppressive frame data proved to overwhelm Rob at top level. Zachray didn't have time to set up his gyro, he didn't have time to prepare a safe landing, he didn't have time for, well, just about anything. Other examples can be seen with top Rob struggling against fast characters like Pikachu, Politana, or Joker. The abundance of these archetypes in top tier gives Rob a lot of trouble being a solo mainable character. Overall, Rob has many incredible strengths, and his results confirm that he's viable in top-level competitive play. However, his weaknesses are also apparent, and as we discussed in our How to Fix Little Mac video, prominent weaknesses almost always hold a character back regardless of their strengths. All things considered, we think Rob doesn't quite make it out of high tier. He might just be top tier online, though. Online, however, is completely up to debate. What do you think of Rob? Let us know, and be sure to subscribe to ProGuides and turn on notifications for more Smash content.